you're hearing the bad stuff. All right, well, it's just about 7, so I suppose we should start. Everybody's here.
So we can start expecting this alleged good stuff any moment now,
the good stuff will show up.
There's Murray right on time.
Speaking of the good stuff showing up, what's up?
Speaking of, let me make sure that...
Sorry, I'm late. I was having dinner with Jay Leno. He said he wouldn't be watching tonight.
What? That son of a bitch, he told me he'd be... He'd check out the show. Hey, everybody. Welcome to all your favorite game shows, the online version. I'm your host, Paul Goebel. Oh, there we go. I'm your host, Paul Goebel. And what we've done tonight is we've taken all your favorite game shows and we've squashed them together. And we're going to play them tonight. We got a bunch of your favorite comedians, as well as Murray Valeriano. They're all on the show. And they're all going to play and we're all going to have a good time. But of course, there's no way I could do this on my own. It's just impossible. So I have my friend to help me do it. He's my scorekeeper. He's my announcer. He's Steve Mandel, everybody. Give it up for Steve. Steve Mandel.
My wake has been blurred.
Have you, have you watched that show on Peacock, Dr. Death?
I have not. I assumed it was like one of those Vice documentaries about legendary wrestler Steve Williams.
No, it's based on a podcast about this doctor who was killing people almost on purpose. But I talked to the producers and they're going to make a show about my comedy career. They're going to call it Dr. Dearth. That's the stuff. Thank you. Yeah, I thank you for playing along, everybody, by not laughing. All right, let's talk about this. Oh, there's Slater. Let's talk about this, Steve. Now, you and I both saw Space Jam, and apparently we both had the same thought. Why are there known criminals and rapists standing courtside watching this kids' movie basketball game?
I understand the concept of the known criminals and putting in... the Penguin and Voldemort and such.
Right.
But I think, as we pointed out earlier, the rapists from Clockwork Orange might have been a bit too much.
Yeah, as bad as the Penguin and Voldemort are, they never raped anyone or beat them to death. They had their own agenda.
We don't know that.
It wasn't just ultra-violence for violence's sake. But I find it funny because I'm sure... Like you were just going, okay, there's Danny DeVito and there's Harry Potter and that. Wait a minute. So what do you say when you're watching that with your kid because you want to relive the experience of watching the first Space Jam? And he goes, who are those guys in the white costumes? What do you say to him?
Scooby-Doo ghosts.
They're going to take off their masks at the end of the movie.
Yeah. They're going to take off something at the end of it.
It was the Clippers all along. But, I mean, I think we can agree that that movie is a piece of shit, right?
That movie was, it had a couple of good giggles, but it was pretty much a giant piece of shit.
How funny is it that they had to spell Toon the correct way because they got sued between the two movies? Apparently Disney owns the spelling of that kind of T-O-O-N, I guess.
Really?
Yeah, they had some kind of court battle between the two movies. Because Disney has Toontown, and it's my understanding that it was originated in Roger Rabbit. So that's when it was first used in a major setting, was in Roger Rabbit, which is a Disney movie. So, but yeah, that's why they had to change it to T-U-N-E. Darn it, we have to spell it correctly! The movie's ruined!
Roger Rabbit has ruined my childhood.
Again.
Getting over the Lola Bunny swap, and now this.
Well, Charles Fleischer ruined my childhood, so why not, right? Are you ready to start this game, Steve? Is there anything you want
to start this game?
You are? Okay, then let's fucking start by playing The Price is Right!
Andrew Slater, come on down. Murray Valeriano, come on down. Danny Ricciardo, come on down. Genevieve Rice, come on down. Craig Anton, come on down. And Shelby Gonzalez, come on down.
Whoa, where'd that come from? Hi, everybody.
Oh, geez.
Welcome to the show. The first game we're going to play tonight is The Price is Right. You all know how The Price is Right works. I got some items here, and I'll show them to you. You're going to bid on them. Whoever gets the closest without going over gets a point. All right. Now, the difference between this Price is Right And the regular Price is Right, of course, is that all these items are $5 or less. All right? Nothing costs more than $5. So do not overbid by $5. All right? Steve, what's up first?
Thor Ragnarok was a huge favorite among fans of the MCU, and their fourth or fifth favorite character was definitely the Valkyrie. Here's her action figure.
There you go. It's a Valkyrie action figure in the box that I got at Target that nobody wanted to buy. We'll start up in the upper corner there. Corey, what do you think I paid for this?
Oh, let's see. I see the yellow tag on it, so yep. It was definitely on clearance. Fantastic. I'm going to bid... The closer you get to it, the fewer pixels it has. It's great. Remember Tic-Tac-Doe in the Avengers universe? $2.98.
$2.98 from Corey. Okay. Genevieve, what's your bid?
You know, I like Tessa Thompson. So
I do too.
I'm gonna go a little bit higher. I'm gonna go $3.49.
$3.49. Okay, nice bid. Okay, Shelby, what do you think?
$3.99.
Very shrewd bid. All right. Craig Anton, what's your bid?
I'm going with $2.75.
$2.75. Nice. Andrew Slater, your bid? I couldn't hear you. Say, we can't hear you. Are you muted?
Oh, no. Oh.
Way to show up for rehearsal, Andrew.
No, we can't hear you. Can anyone hear it, Slater?
It's always the fancy mics that don't work.
No, I don't know what...
10 seconds and then boot him, right?
You could hold up a piece of paper with your bid on it if you want, Slater, but I don't know what the problem is.
For the entire show, please just do it in notes.
Or semaphore.
Put it in the chat.
No, we can't hear a word you're saying. It looks like you're saying some funny stuff, though. All right. While he's trying to figure that out, Murray, what's your bid?
Yes. Can I see it again?
Sure.
All right. I'm going $4.99 because I'm not racist.
$4.99. So if it's not $4.99, does that mean you are racist?
It means the whoever priced it is racist.
Ah, good call. Steve, who's racist? Mm-hmm.
Well, Corey knew the exact amount of racism at $2.98. He is our winner.
Whoa, well done, Corey. Nice. You guys on the money.
Congratulations.
Well done.
Guess I just who spends too much time at Target.
I just wish Andrew Slater was here to enjoy this.
All right. That was fun, Paul.
Steve,
see you next time.
Wait, there's more show, Craig. Oh, geez. All right, man. We've lost two of them now.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you now.
I heard Andrew.
There you go.
Yeah, I think it was all of you guys were fucked up, not me.
Probably, yeah, that's probably right. All right.
Your mustache on mute.
Craig, Steve, what's the next item up for bids?
Up next is a box of modeling clay from Crayola. It comes in four different colors, and much like our host, this clay stays soft no matter how long you play with it.
Oh, my God.
All right, so it's modeling clay. It comes in the big chunks. See, there it is in the box. It's all there, but I bought it on sale. So Corey got it right. So Genevieve, you bid first this time. What do you think? Oh, jeez.
I'm going to go with 99 cents.
Genevieve says 99 cents. Shelby, what's your bid?
$1.99.
$1.99 from Shelby Gonzalez. Slater, let's hear it.
50 cents.
Nice. It was worth waiting for. Murray, what's your bid?
$2.99.
$2.99 for Murray. And Craig, you're last.
$1.50.
And then, actually, Corey, you're last.
I was going to say, $1.65.
All right. All the bids are in. Steve, who gets the clay?
The actual retail price is $1.50. Craig is our winner.
Well done, Craig Anton. Okay, now you can go. The show's over. Thank you, Craig, for being here. All right.
You got your Play-Doh. Go home.
Steve, what's the next item?
What's the hottest Halloween costume this year?
Oh.
Well, it's definitely not Lego Batgirl, especially one with a Goodwill sticker affixed to her face.
So someone at Goodwill thought it was a good idea to put the sticker right in the center of their fucking forehead. Because when you're playing Lego Batgirl, you want everybody to know you got your costume at Target. I mean, at Goodwill. All right. So who won that last one? Craig? So that means, Corey, you bid first.
Before I bid, how much do I have to pay you to keep that on for the entire show?
Well, how much did you pay Murray when he won on your game show?
I paid him $10 because I gave him interest because I just paid him today for being on in January.
Check your Venmo, Murray.
All right. I just did. I'm like, that motherfucker, wait until he knew he had to see me.
Of course.
Before he paid up.
It's true. Absolutely. 100%. Hey, Game Show Network made me wait 4 months. So you got off worse.
Hey, I had to wait 90 days to get my money from Greed.
A friend of mine was on Match Game and on ABC, and they took forever to show the episodes because they're waiting for not football to show.
Right.
And the day where the contract said, either you had like we'll pay you within 6 months of showing the episode or this like night, you know, six right. months after you tape it. He emailed them on the day, "Where's my money?" And then they aired it 2 weeks later. Incredible.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
That's $175.
$175 for this gorgeous mask. Genevieve, what do you think?
I'm gonna go with 99 cents.
99 cents. She goes down low. Shelby, this looks like something you'd wear. What do you say?
Why would I ever?
Because you want to be Lego Batgirl for Christmas. I mean, for Halloween or Christmas.
For Christmas, yeah.
Arbor
See
Day.
How much my family will buy me back for Christmas then, yeah. I feel like somebody already said $1.50.
Yes.
Somebody said $1.50 already?
I think so.
Shit. $1.99?
$1.99?
That's too high, though. No. Can I change that? I don't like that.
Yes. That. Go ahead.
$150.
$150.
Somebody already said $150. No. Okay, cool.
All right. Slater, your bid.
$265.
$265 from Andrew Slater. Murray, what do you think?
50 cent.
50 cent, he says, down low and slow. And Craig, what's your bid?
I'm going with $1.
Even $1. Someone's got it on the nose, I think, Steve. Who got it?
The actual retail price is 99 cents. Fiona wins this round.
Yes, Fiona Rice got herself a Lego Batgirl mask.
I'm excited. I have Groupon, so I get that sticker off, too.
Oh, is that what you do? Oh, man. All right, Steve. Got a couple more here. What's next?
This next item up for bids is a box of Sun-Made Raisin Snacks. 7 individual pouches of golden raisins flavored like strawberry, as if regular raisins weren't bad enough.
So, you want to give your kids a healthy snack? It ain't this, because it's got a ton of strawberry sugary corn syrup in it. I'm sure it tastes heinous. So, Shelby, you bid first on these.
$0.99. Those
90.
Look horrible.
Yeah, they're sour. 99 cents from Shelby. Slater, your bid?
$1.89.
$1.89. Murray Valeriano.
Give me a little size here. Well, how big are those? Show, put those next to your beard.
Well, they're.
Yeah, show us how big your raisins are.
Yeah. Next to the raisins in your beard.
They're in pouches. They're in pouches in the box, but I've never opened it. I can't open this or the value will go down. What does it say? Seven, right? Isn't it seven pouches? Yeah, seven pouches.
Seven pouches. It's $2.99.
All right. Craig, what do you think?
I'm going to say 45 cents.
Nice bid. And Corey, you're last. Oh, no. Genevieve's last. Corey, you're second to last. What do you say?
I'm going to say 249.
249, good bid. And Genevieve, you're last. What's your bid?
You know, I like raisins, and I come from a family that likes raisins. So I'm going to give a full $1.29 to these sour raisin packs.
Perfect bid. Steve, who's got it?
The actual retail price is $1.46. Fiona gets to eat tonight.
Ah, nice. She knows her raisins.
Oh, man.
She's on fire. So
wait,
close.
Did you say seven pouches?
Yes.
Is it seven pouches?
Yes, I said seven.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry.
I thought nine. Sorry.
Yeah. All right, last item, Steve. What is it?
Are you having a birthday party and inviting more than eight people? Well, then you're dumb. However, if you only have a few friends over, this eight pack of birthday party cups is perfect for you.
So there you go, eight cups. They all say happy birthday on them. Once again, Shelby, you bid first. What do you think?
49 cents.
49 cents down low. Genevieve, your bid? Or I'm sorry, Slater, your bid. Genevieve's last. Slater.
99 cents.
He says 99. Okay, Murray, eight cups.
50 cents.
50 cents from Murray.
Wait. Did you say eight cups?
Yes, eight cups.
Yes. Yeah.
50, all right.
50 cents.
Craig Anton.
I'm going with 75 cents.
75. We got a lot of under a dollar bids here. Corey?
79 cents.
79. And Genevieve, you're last. What do you say?
I'm going to go with 89 cents.
All right. Everybody's bid. Steve, who's got that last item?
The actual retail price is 75 cents. Party at Craig's house.
Invite eight people over, Craig, because you're having a party.
All of us. All of us on the show can come over.
All of us but one.
Well, Craig's got his own cup. He doesn't need those. He's got a cup that says his name on it. All right. That is the end of the Price is Right round. Well done, you guys. Why don't we take a little break and slow things down? And we'll meet all the contestants. You want to do that, Steve?
I can do that.
All right. Who's on the show tonight?
Andrew Slater has performed on Last Comic Standing, recorded a comedy special for Dry Bar, and made his late night stand-up debut on Conan.
Oh, Conan. So now that Conan is no longer on the air, how long are you going to use that credit?
Longer now. Now it's like the shit you keep in your house, you know? It's prestige. It's antique, you know?
Right.
Those are
true.
Worth more now. You want credits.
It's like saying saying you were on the Tonight Show when Carson was there.
No, the best one is A&E Evening at the Improv. That is the most valuable credit left.
Is
I
it?
Just checked my baseball prospectus card guide. So A&E Evening at the Improv can go for a lot of money on eBay right now.
Really? All right.
Ben Sullivan would be a good investment.
Now Slater, it's my understanding that in that beautiful big house you're living in, like we can see behind you, you have an infant.
Isn't it gorgeous?
It's nice. But you have an infant there with you, living with you. This is the time in your life and your baby's life when things are really getting crazy. Because your baby is no longer just a little piece of flesh. They're learning things and looking at things and understanding things. How does that make you feel?
First of all, I like the way you put that. Well, yes, I have a baby living with me. It's not a roommate. Who had a daughter. She didn't move in.
Wait.
Because she needed a place to crash.
I thought she was going to college and you were renting her a room.
No.
Oh, okay.
No. She is my baby daughter.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
that's nice.
One day that I.
That's nice that you rented
right
a room.
Now,
yeah, go ahead.
She's upstairs right now making these precious memories, and I'm out around And one day I'll tell her I missed her first words because I was on all your favorite game shows.
That's something our parents didn't do. Our parents just said, yeah, I wasn't there for your birth because I was busy.
Yeah. It wasn't golf. It was something even worse.
Well, none of our dads were there, probably. Maybe they were smoking back when you could smoke in hospitals. All right. Well, where can people go to learn about your comedy routines and stuff like that, Andrew?
AndrewComedy.com. I've got dates up there now, finally, thank God. And so if you want to come see a show, it's the best way to find out.
There you go. All right. Well, thank you for being here, Slater. I appreciate you doing the show. Who's next, Steve?
Oh, yeah. Thanks for having me.
Murray Valeriano is a comedian and writer out of Los Angeles.
Thank you.
That's it?
if he's gonna use his Conan credit, then I want to use my At Midnight credit because that was canceled also.
Yeah, go ahead.
There you go.
Okay.
Murray Valeriano is a comedian and writer out of Los Angeles who was once on At Midnight.
Oh, really? Murray, let's talk about how you were on At Midnight. How did you book that?
Well, it was a lot, you know, you had to know somebody, and that's about it. Mm-hmm. I'd rather talk about my new game show called For What It's Worth.
Yeah?
Music and comedy game show you can get at Murray Valeriano Comedy.
Tell people about the show. It's like kind of a music trivia show. But it's
music trivia, it's and music that. Games. So we come up with different games every week and different trivia, and it's a lot of fun.
Now, do you have to know a lot about
comedians on it?
Do you have to know a lot about music to excel on your show?
It helps, but I write every episode, so I write it with fun hints and clues throughout the trivia, and then all the games are range from anything from make up a funny. Title for an album, introduce your least favorite band at Madison Square Garden. Real fun games you can fuck around with. It's a lot of fun.
That sounds like fun. I have watched a few. Where can people see that?
You can get it on my YouTube channel, youtube.com/C/ Murray Valeriano Comedy, because YouTube doesn't make it fucking easy to do anything.
But
on
they have
anymore,
a they
so
have a search bar.
Platforms.
You could just type in your name in the search bar, right?
Hey, I worked hard to get that /C/.dot Murray Valeriano. Use it.
I just go push a thing on your and say Murray Valeriano Comedy. It'll take a while, but it'll eventually show up. all right. Well, Murray, thank you for doing the show. Thank you for coming back. We appreciate you being here. There's your applause.
Thanks for having me. I just want to say I haven't seen Andrew Slater in 5 years. And I haven't seen Craig Anton in a decade.
Well, because
so it's nice to see everybody.
They moved away. Nobody lives close to. I think everybody here lives in a different place, except the people in Arizona. There's three people in Arizona, and everyone else is in a different state altogether. We got Maryland, Oregon, Arizona, California, and where are you, Craig?
Georgia.
Georgia, and that's the only place where weed is not legal of all these places, right?
Well, once you get your election bullshit settled, then you can fucking work on weed.
Yeah, we understand it's easy to vote there, so good job. Who's next, Steve?
Corey Anatotto is a podcaster and semi-professional game show host. Whoops. Can't wait to go to bed.
Oh, Corey, now when I asked you to do the show, your response was, "Let me ask my wife," which I found funny, yes. But that means because she works early in the morning and you're way out in Maryland, so it's late for you. I assume that's what that was about.
That is exactly right, Paul. My wife has a normal job where she goes into an office. Meanwhile, I finagled my way into sitting my ass on this exact chair every day for at least 4 hours.
Good gig.
So
it wasn't that you had to. It wasn't that you had to ask your wife for permission. She was gonna.
Right. It's a logistical.
I
want to make sure that she doesn't have to wake up tomorrow.
Of course.
And have nightmares of me shouting 49 cents for the Batman mask.
Happy wife, happy life. I totally get it. You don't have to explain that to me. But you also have some game shows that you do that you've come up
with.
Boy,
howdy do I.
Like, give us. Yeah, so, tell us about some of them.
So my big online podcast is called Pop Off. It's graciously stolen from the library of Mark Goodson and Bill Todman. We get four comedians to answer very silly questions. And once their logic runs out, then we tell them to get fucked. And we do it for literally dollars. Murray was a champion, and I just paid him $10.
Ah, so people really do win.
People really do win on Pop Off.
People do win.
People really wait for that money.
No, just you. You were the only person that waited. Everyone else got paid pretty much day of.
Right away.
I don't know why you don't like me.
He had to make a lot of interest.
I'm jealous of all your skateboards with no wheels. So, Pop Off, we do that.
That's a hoverboard.
We do that once a month. Oh yeah, that's right. That makes sense.
I'm jealous of all your Christmas lights with no trees. Fuck you.
What's the big game show thing you have coming up, Corey?
We are very happy to be back in a place that you can stand and drink at. It's called The Crown here in Baltimore. I'm doing Game Show Gauntlet, which is, it's like this, but with fewer funny people. It's just me and a bunch of random audience people who are drunk and think they know anything.
Fewer?
And I show them they don't.
How is there fewer funny people than what we have on this show? That is quite the achievement.
There's Steve and me, and then on Gauntlet, it's just me.
I see. So you're really starting out at a deficit for sure.
Absolutely. And that's going to be August 11 at the Crown in Baltimore.
And
be there.
Will that be cast on the internet? Could people watch it on the internet?
Depends on if I need my phone or not. I don't know.
All right. Well, we're doing
in-person things now.
We'll stay tuned for those of us who can't be there. You were going
to
say, Steve?
To Corey for acknowledging my comedic brilliance.
All right. Well, thank you for coming back, Corey. Now, for those of you who don't know, Corey's actually probably the biggest winner on this show because in the last round, Corey ran the whole round, answered every single question correctly, and was the champion. So Corey is definitely the horse to beat in this game. Thanks for being here, Corey. Who's left, Steve?
Genevieve Rice is a comedian, mother, and not a raccoon.
All right. I can verify two of those things. you were just telling us before the show you're going back out into the wilds of Phoenix to tell jokes again amongst the peoples.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that?
conflicted.
Yeah.
But I'm excited. I got some good shows coming up. If you're leaving your house these days. I'm opening for Greg Warren at Stir Crazy this Friday and Saturday. So excited about that. And then I am also doing, I'm on one of the book spots at the Bridge open mic in Tempe.
Nice. And you're still doing your online show just like mine, the Little Bird Showcase, right?
Yeah, we're doing that on Thursdays. So keeping the professional Zoom account alive.
Why not? Now that everybody knows how it works, why not? We've opened up a new form. Remember when the internet opened up and like all these kids got famous on YouTube and stuff? It was like a whole nother stream and way to get famous. That's what this Zoom thing is now. There's going to be like a subsection of the entertainment business that only exists on Zoom. People are going to be super famous. All right.
Who is the Zoom equivalent of Tia Tequila?
Me? Is that what you were trying? Did you want me to say that? Is that what you were going for?
No, I was just throwing that out at random. I just wanted to say Tia Tequila. All right.
Well, only in the sense that people are sick of me. I'm the male Tila Tequila in the sense that no one wants me around. All right. Well, where can people go to watch that, the Bird Showcase?
All right. That is at the Little Bird Showcase. You can find the links on Bird City Comedy Facebook page.
There you go to the Bird City Comedy on Facebook. There you go. Thank you very much, Genevieve, for being here. Steve, who do we got next?
Craig Anton is from Omaha, Nebraska, and lives in Savannah, Georgia now. Craig and Paul appeared in the same episode of Curb Your Enthusiasm, which made other people happy and super rich. As an actor, Craig has been seen on Mad Men, Key and Peele, The Middle, Weeds, Entourage, The Office, and more. He is noted for never having listened to a true crime podcast.
That's very impressive. I always forget that we were in the same episode of Curb Your Enthusiasm because we didn't have any scenes together. It was almost two completely different stories. But that was back when you lived in L.A. and you were an actor. Now you mold the minds of young actors your own self. Tell people what you do now for a living.
Is that true? Yes, I sell NFTs. a lot of money in it.
Yeah.
I don't know what they are.
What's your last one go for? How much you get for it?
16 million.
Wow. Sure. Nice. I got to get in on these NFTs. But in your spare time, you're also a professor, right?
Is that true?
Yes.
Is that true?
Yes. Tell people yes, about what you do for monies.
Well, I am a...
Oh, for Christ's sake.
Is that Slater's or Genevieve's? This is bullshit.
No, that's actually my wife. She's younger than you guys thought.
What? I am a professor at Savannah College of Art and Design.
Okay.
And it's fantastic. I love it. I get to, you know, talk about the craft every day, get up on our feet, goof off, and do some make-em-ups. And then I also do some theater on the side and also some music on the side too.
And the students must love you because you're certainly affable enough, but you're also very knowledgeable. You have such a well of knowledge to teach them. How often do they find something online that you did and show it?
And well, that's the fun part, is they have no idea who I am.
Really?
And then they'll come to class maybe 2 months in, they'll say, "Hey, I saw you on a thing last night.
I was watching King of Queens and you and that guy," I was like, "That guy looks like Mr. Anton."
It's too late. They've canceled me. They've checked out on whatever it is I have to share. So
they're not impressed at all by anything you do. Well, how long have you been doing that? How long have you been teaching that?
5 years. About to start my sixth year.
Wow. So you're entrenched.
Great. Love it.
This is it. You're not going back to show business. You put the whole Hollywood in your rear view, huh?
I just put two auditions on tape today. I've got two more tomorrow.
Oh, yeah? The Man on the Moon sequel?
Yeah.
Finally making that?
No, but I am doing the Jim Carrey story.
Yeah? That seems like a natural, the Jim Carrey story starring you.
As performed by Andy Kaufman. Yeah.
That makes perfect sense.
All righty then.
Oh, very good. All right. So actually, if you want to see something awesome, go to YouTube in the search bar, Google Andy Kaufman, Craig Anton. It's one of the coolest videos.
There you go.
It is very cool.
Milos Forman.
Yeah, right? You know, I was in that movie. I had one line. I went rawr at the very beginning of the movie when Andy's doing his "the cow goes blah" and they switch to the club, and Milos Forman actually directed me. That was a good day. I was like, "Hey," cause I was an extra. And so I got that line and I go to the guy and I'm like, "Hey, I got a line. Can you bump me up?" And he's like, "No, not for that." And I was like, "Oh, well, fuck you then." And I called SAG and I'm like, "Hey, I got a line on this thing. I need to get bumped up." And they're like, "Okay, we'll open a file, but just don't hold your breath because we have to wait for the movie to come out to see it." And I'm like, "Okay." And then it came out and I called SAG and I'm like, because there's a big fucking close up on my face. It's obviously me. And I called SAG and I said, "Hey, remember this thing?" And they're like, "Well, did you open a file, you know, 6 months ago or whatever?" And I'm like, "Yeah, I sure as fuck did." And they're like, "Okay, so we'll contact Universal and ask them what they think, and then we'll get back to you." So I call them in a month. I'm like, "So what did Universal say?" And they go, "Well, Universal said Milos Forman has Final Cut, so they can't give us a copy of the film. Only Forman can do that." So we left him a message. And they were waiting for Milos Forman to call him back. So I'm like, all right, what if he doesn't call back? What do you do then? And they're like, well, then we'll just give you the money. So, long story longer, I'm now, I get residuals from Man on the Moon because of that. So that's you young actors. Don't ever fucking good let job. Some PA on a set tell you what's up because they don't know dick. All right, who's left, Steve?
That was a great introduction to Craig Anton.
I waited until after he bragged about his teacher job. Jesus. All right, who's left, Steve?
Shelby Gonzalez is a website developer and comedian who quit her job and cashed in her 401k to drive to California for a weekend to see Devo at a music festival.
Good stuff, and you have no regrets.
No regrets.
I like that. Shelby, you played the games many times. You played this game many times. In fact, we just went back to doing them live at the Grid, and you were the winner. How did that feel, being the champion of the new version of all your favorite game shows live?
Proudest moment of my life.
I'm sure it was. And you were earlier when I, because somebody bailed and you were nice enough to fill in, but you said I might not be there because why? What were you doing?
I had purchased a ticket earlier today to do Seinfeld trivia, a virtual Zoom Seinfeld trivia that happened to actually end just as this was starting. So and, it worked out.
And how did you do?
I did not great.
Yeah. They got the hardcore Seinfeld nerds.
I'm like, if I know anything, I know Seinfeld, but there were, I think, 29 teams. I think I came in 21st. Right? They gave us some tough questions. It was hard.
Yeah. Well, like we said, the nerds definitely come out in droves for stuff like that. Because you know how nerds don't like to leave their house. Absolutely. But you also have your own business. Tell people about that. What do you do with that?
Yeah, I make dope fucking websites. If you need a website, hit me up. I'm at fredflash.com. You can see my portfolio, a little bit more about me there. Actually, one of your buddies just hit me up last night and said that you referred him. And
yeah, he texted me.
I like him so far.
Yeah, he texted me and said, because we had talked about it a long time ago. But yeah, I told him you knew what you were doing and you get it. Because it's when you want to make a cool website, like as a performer, it's hard to find someone who gets it. You know, there's so many fucking nerds who are like, well, how is this? And you're like, well, no, that's supposed to be a joke. Yeah, it's a never mind. So I recommend Shelby because she understands what you're trying to do, especially if you're a comic or a performer or something like that.
Yeah, it seems like unintentionally, but just my two favorite things are comedy and breweries, and in addition to like technology and making websites. And I like how all of those things are coming together. It's pretty cool because most of the websites I've done have been for breweries and comedians, and it's pretty cool. I dig it.
Excellent. All right. Well, it's good to have a niche. It's good to know your strengths. All right. Well, thank you for being here, Shelby. I appreciate you filling in at the last minute. Definitely. Is there anyone left, Steve?
That should do it.
That's everyone. All right. Then let's move on to our next game. Where is it? Yeah. Let's play the match game. How's that sound? There it is. You guys know how the match game works. We mentioned it earlier. I got some questions here. I'm going to ask them. They all have a blank in them. Then I'm going to go to Steve. Then you guys have to write down your name. Or not your name. Write down your answer on a piece of paper.
I got this round.
Yeah. Write down it. And then we'll go to Steve. He'll fill in the blank. And so that's the point. You're trying to match Steve, all right? So I will give a point to everybody who matches Steve. And I will also give a point to the most popular answer. You match each other and Steve just didn't get it, I'll give you a point that way. But this is a good chance to score some points, because if you match Steve and you get the most popular answer, I'll give you 3 points. So it's a good opportunity for you guys with no points to jump ahead. All right, here we go. Here's the first question. I have to find a new acupuncturist. Last time I was there, he stuck a needle in my blank. Oh, I have to find a new acupuncturist. Last time I was there, he stuck a needle in my blank. All right. That should be enough. Steve, I need to find a new acupuncturist because last time I went to see this guy, he stuck a needle in my blank.
My eye.
Stuck a needle in my eye. It's all blurred.
Cross my heart, hope to die, stick a needle in my eye.
Yeah, I remember that. All right. So eye is what we're looking for to match. Let's go to Corey first up in the corner. Corey, Steve said stick a needle in my eye. Is that what you said?
I don't know why I didn't say that. I'm, you know what? We were talking about how weed is legal in Maryland, and I'll blame it on that. I said taint.
Stuck a needle in my taint. Actually, no. That's why I need to find a new guy, because you stopped sticking it in my taint. I'm like, what am I paying you for? All right, not a match, but a good answer. Genevieve, did you say I?
I did not. I went a different direction. I've had acupuncture. It worked really well for me. But I'd be pretty mad if an acupuncturist stuck it in my car.
In your car, yes. That probably wouldn't help. And also do damage to your car. What the fuck? Not a match. Shelby, we're looking for I. What did you say?
That's my favorite answer.
What does it say? Ass! Yes, stuck a needle in my ass. What is it? Hope to sass, stick a needle in my ass. Not a match. These are good answers, though. Slater, did you say I?
I did not. I said in my...
my ring light.
HMO.
In my HMO, sure. Because it's covered by insurance. It's a blue
card. I don't have paper.
I know. We know that you've gone digital. You don't have any paper or pens in your house.
I have all sorts of problems.
No audio, no paper. Weird baby living in your house. All right, Murray, we're looking for I. Did you say that?
Yeah. Some of us are here to win this, motherfucker.
Yeah? He says I. Oh, I guess you were talking about yourself. Good job. All right, that's a point for Murray because he said I. Craig, what did you say?
I also said I.
Wait, no, that says ass. That says ass. It doesn't say
I. Sure
I. No, you need to get your glasses.
That's the eye of your butt.
Yeah, it's a brown eye. Yeah. It's a brown eye, but not, I don't know that that's what Steve was looking for. So, okay, one match from Murray Valeriano. Good job. Here we go. Next question. Dumb Dora is so dumb.
How dumb is she?
That instead of bringing baked beans to the cookout, she brought blank beans. Dumb Dora is so dumb that instead of bringing baked beans to the cookout, she brought blank beans. I had to check to see if blank beans were a thing because it sounds like it is, but it isn't. But Steve, I know you and Dumb Dora dated for a while, so this probably shouldn't surprise you. But she's so dumb that instead of bringing baked beans to the cookout, she brought blank beans. What'd you say?
I said stoned beans.
Stoned. Instead of baked, they were stoned. Sure. All right. I see where you're going.
From Maryland.
Right. So let's go to Maryland. Let's go live to Maryland with Corey Annotato. Did you say stoned beans, Corey?
Steve is a fucking wild card, man. I was like, okay, yeah, you stick needles in eyes. That makes sense. I said jelly beans.
Oh, jelly beans. That's a good answer. Yes.
I cannot get a hold on this game.
Yeah, Steve, he's all over. He zigs when you think he's going to zag. Absolutely. All right, Genevieve, did you say stoned beans?
Unfortunately, I did not, and I also had Ronald Reagan on the brain, because I also said jelly
beans. Hey, two people said jelly beans. All right, so far, that's the most popular answer. If it remains as such, you two will get a point. Shelby, what kind of bean did you write down?
I said baked beans.
Wait, I said she didn't bring baked beans, or did you mean a different baked. Kind of baked? Like, instead of bringing baked beans, she brought baked beans.
No, she brought vape beans, like fucking sweet clouds, bro.
Oh, vape beans. Okay. All right, nice. Vape beans. All right. Yeah, all right, I like it. No match, though. Slater, we're looking for stoned beans. What'd you say?
I went the other way with from Steve. I went with sober beans.
Oh, the opposite. Baked beans, sober beans. That's a good one, yeah. No match, but that's a good answer. I like it. Murray, did you match anything at all?
No, I said fried beans.
Fried instead of baked. See, there's so many different ways you can go. The preparation, the pun. I bet the funniest answer, though, is going to come from Craig Anton. Let's hear it, Craig.
No.
I've been down south too long, and we do a lot of low country boil. So I said
boiled
beans, because that would be disgusting.
Boiled beans. I understand boiled peanuts is a thing there. Have you ever had those?
Oh, no. Yes, I have.
They're gross.
Yeah, it sounds gross. All right, so Corey and Genevieve matched each other, so they both scored a point in that round. Good job. Here we go. Next question. They matched each other. Why is that so hard to understand? All right, here's the next question.
It's a weird rule.
You know, Candace Bergen is the daughter of ventriloquist Edgar Bergen, and apparently when he died, she had him blanked. So, you know, Candy Bergen is the daughter of ventriloquist Edgar Bergen. And apparently when he died, she had him blanked. I don't know what the answer would be on this one. It's completely open-ended. But, Steve, I know you're familiar with Candace Bergen and her father, Edgar Bergen, and his ventriloquism. Apparently when he died, she had him blanked. What did she have done to him, Steve?
Because he's a ventriloquist, she had him subtitled.
All right, she had him subtitled so people could see what he's saying. All right, that works as good as anything else. Corey, did you say subtitled? I bet you didn't.
Oh, I didn't say subtitled.
What did you say?
I said stuck on her hand.
Ah, like had her stuck on her hand. Sure, like a dummy. All right, no match. Genevieve, we're looking for subtitled.
I did not do subtitled. I went a different route with mummified.
Oh, had him mummified. I would pay to see an Edgar Bergen mummy. No match. Shelby Sacramento, what did you say?
Okay, for some reason, when I heard ventriloquist, I thought of like fucking marionette, so I said hanged.
Hanged him. He was dead and she hanged him. All right, that's fine. I don't have a problem with that. I like it. Slater? Looking for subtitled.
Yeah, no, I went with stuffed. She
had him stuffed. Like, okay, I thought someone was going to say that. Sure, that's good. Murray, what'd you say?
I don't know if Slater and I get points for this one, but I said stuffed in a suitcase.
That's a different kind of stuff, but I like that answer.
I think stuffed.
I think it counts.
Thank you, Andrew.
Stuffed in a suitcase and stuffed with stuffing are two different things. Craig Anton, can you make some sense of this? Oh, he also said stuffed. All right. So that means Slater gets a point and Craig gets a point because they both matched each other. Good job.
Murray gets a half point.
Sorry. Wait, what? Did somebody say something? All right.
I heard Murray gets a half point.
Sounded like it was coming from the suitcase.
Murray's quite the ventriloquist. All right. Next question. This one comes right from an episode of Match Game. Howard Cosell's mouth is so big that he could eat a blank sideways. Howard Cosell's mouth is so big that he could eat a blank sideways. They had a lot of questions about Howard Cosell on the Match Game. He was a subject on there quite often. All right, Steve, you're familiar with Howard Cosell, the late Howard Cosell.
I am.
Apparently his mouth,
he had a large mouth.
Yeah, it was so big that he could eat a blank sideways. What do you think?
It's a traffic cone.
A traffic cone sideways. Wow, that is more difficult. Because if you eat it this way, the long way, you can build up to it. It gets bigger as you go. But yeah, sideways, you just got to take the whole thing in. That ain't easy. All right. I guarantee you nobody said traffic cone, though. Corey, what did you say?
Well, Paul, I think you'll be surprised that, no, I didn't fucking say traffic. Wide World of Sportsman, football.
Oh, a sideways football. Oh. Very good. That makes sense. Genevieve, what did you say?
Yeah, I also went with football.
Oh, yes. Two footballs. All right. So there's two matches again. Corey and Genevieve, they got a strong team going. Shelby, what did you say?
I said dick.
So he could put a dick in his mouth sideways.
Sideways?
What is the side?
Why not?
Whoa. Yeah. All right. I don't want to get into the semantics. You probably know more about it than I
would like to.
Yeah, can we get a diagram of some sort?
I would like to get into the semantics of this.
Murray, I'll send you one of my Pornhub bookmarks. Hold on.
Okay. Yeah, if you pop it into Google, I'm sure something will pop up.
So. Sideways dick sucking. All right. Slater, what did you say?
It's like a corn on the cob.
A little more. Corn on the cob.
The old typewriter.
Ding.
I went little cleaner over here. Yeah. I went with Costco hot dog.
He could pick a Costco hot dog sideways.
Big hot dog.
Yeah, that's they are big. Big. That's impressive. It's pretty big. Not a match though. Murray, did you say traffic cone?
Well, no, but I think I get 2 points because I said hot dog.
Uh-huh.
That counts. Come what? On.
Well, why?
But I also call my dick. I also call my dick my hot dog, so I should get points shared with Shelby. Wow.
Why do you call your dick a hot dog?
Because I put mustard on it.
I'll give you 1 point because you matched Slater because you both said hot dog. And Slater will get
don't
a point.
Don't you dare put ketchup on it, motherfuckers. No, don't you I dare never. Put ketchup on it.
It's a brat, is my understanding. So that's a point for Murray and a point for Slater. Craig, you're the last one. What did you say?
Hoagie.
Oh, a big hoagie. Delicious.
Hoagie, yeah.
Or hoagie, as they say.
Hoagie.
All right.
Hoagie in a glass of water.
Water. We scored water. Some points in that round. That was a good one. Okay, one question left. Here we go. I was watching an old episode of Columbo the other day, and instead of wearing a raincoat, he was wearing a blank. Yeah, I was checking out this old episode of Columbo on Peacock the other day, and instead of wearing a raincoat, he was wearing a blank. One of the opening credits we saw was Mrs. Columbo, starring Captain Janeway. That was ridiculous. All right, so Steve.
Is that real?
Yes, that's a real show. It's called Mrs. Columbo.
Oh my, I gotta see that.
Yeah, and then they changed it to
so bad now.
Then they changed the title to Kate Columbo to make it a little less misogynist, and then they decided to get rid of the premise altogether and just call it Kate Loves a Mystery. And it was just about some lady who solved mysteries. But there were episodes where she wore a raincoat and smoked cigars. It's fucking horrible. All right. So, Steve, last one, watching an old episode of Columbo, and instead of wearing a raincoat, he was wearing a...
leisure suit.
A leisure suit. Oh, yeah. Columbo liked to get...
It was the 70s.
Yeah, he liked to be comfortable, if nothing else. All right, so we're looking for leisure suit. Some of you young people probably don't even know what that is. But Corey, is that what you said? Leisure suit?
I didn't say leisure suit, but I since you said it was on Peacock, I assumed it's one of those super cut episodes.
Yeah.
So I assume Peter Falk was in a wry smile and nothing else.
All right. It's an adult episode of Columbo. Columboob. Not a match, though. Genevieve, did you say where? What? Wait, what did you say again? Wearing a leisure suit. That's what we're looking for. Is that what you said?
You know, I think I was close, but just emotionally, just sense of self-satisfaction.
Sense of self-satisfaction. I think that matches what
Corey said.
I want
Corey a match for the wry smile. Yeah.
I will give it to you. There we go. Here. I'll give you guys both a point. Why not? You've been matching all through the game, so that one makes sense too. Okay, point for Genevieve, point for Corey. Slater, did you say leisure suit?
Well, no, I did not. I said he was wearing a Snuggie.
A Snuggie. Sure.
For anybody?
Yeah, I own many but Snuggies.
Also, I'd like to point out that a lot of Columbo's convictions were overturned on DNA evidence.
Oh, really?
So he wasn't quite the detective people made him out to be.
He did. It seemed like he immediately decided somebody did it and then figured out how. And he's like, I think you did it, and I'm going to show everybody that you did it, and here's how you did it. Yeah, it was almost all
So you mean he's a police officer?
All right, Murray, did you say leisure suit?
I did not. I excitedly said umbrella hat.
What's an umbrella hat?
Little hearts for Corey.
Oh, like one of those hats that keep the sun in the... Oh, my God.
No, it's an umbrella, but it's on a hat thing, and you wear it like that.
Yeah.
Anton knows what I'm talking about.
I've seen them before, yeah.
You guys live in Arizona. You don't know what the fuck rain is.
Well, they're
Anton
used...
Anton lives in Georgia. He knows what's up.
They're used more for the sun than they are the rain. Craig?
No, they're not.
Yes, because in the rain, they get wet and blow away.
No, they're on your head.
It's cheap. All right. Craig said velvet cape. He's wearing a velvet cape. I like that. He turns around. One more thing, ma'am. Very dramatically. All right, Shelby. What?
Where did you buy those shoes? That was always this.
Very good.
I said face mask.
Wearing a face mask. Oh, geez. I don't want to get into it. That sounds weird. All right. That's the last question in this match game round. Let's go ahead and recap the scores so we can see where everybody is. Steve, let us know what's going on. What do you got?
We have Genevieve in the lead with 5 points, followed by Corey and Craig with 4 points apiece, and Andrew, Murray, and Shelby at 2 points each.
All right. So everybody's on the board, at least. Everybody's got some points. So it's still anybody's game. Let's move on to our next game. This one's everybody's favorite. Where is it? Let's go on to the hashtag wars. Hey, 80s Lisa, thanks for being here. The hashtag wars, the way we do it is I gave all these guys a hashtag and told them to come up with as many funny responses as they could to said hashtag. And we'll just go through and read them. If it's funny, you get a point. If not, no points. All right. The hashtag we went with was lesser superheroes. Lesser superheroes. Examples would be Cadet Marvel or Chiropractor Doom. He's not a doctor. Or Crimping Iron Man. I originally said Curling Iron Man, and my wife said, nah, crimping. Go with crimping. So give her credit for that. So you guys get how it works. Let's start with Corey. Give us your first one. Knock us out, Corey.
Captain Canada.
Captain Canada, sure. All right, nice. Genevieve?
Ant-Man.
Are you Ant-Man or Cant-Man? Andrew Slater, what do you got?
Centrum Silver Surfer.
He is getting old. Murray?
Get up there.
Nice hat you got back there, Murray.
Thank you. The facial tick.
Excellent. Gorgeous. Craig Anton.
Truth or dare, devil.
I like it. He corners a suspect and then he says, okay, truth or dare, and they're like, well, truth, I guess. And then he asks them who their crush
that's
is.
That's a bad combination with Ben Affleck.
Shelby, what do you got?
Heaven Boy.
As opposed to Hellboy, right. Nice. Okay, Corey, back to you.
Let's do Gastro Boy.
As opposed to Astro Boy. Nice, he's a boy robot with farting problems. Okay, Genevieve?
All right. Captain Marv Albert.
Pour one out for Captain Marv Albert. R.I.P. Nice. Slater.
Aquavelva Man.
Sure. Well, there's something about an Aquavelva Man, right? Look up that on YouTube. Murray, what do you got?
I got super girly.
Super girly. All
right. Instead of fighting crime, she just squeals.
It's very effeminate. Okay, who's her archenemy? A mouse? Craig, what do you got?
Instead of the Green Arrow, the chartreuse prick.
That sounds like something they do on the Venture Brothers. That's definitely a Venture Brothers character. Shelby, what do you got?
Captain Marble.
Captain Marble. Sure. Very good. All right, let's go ahead and machine gun them. Just read off the list. Corey, go ahead. Knock us out.
Okay, the ultraviolet lantern. His only superpower is seeing where semen is hiding. Sprite Wing. He throws lemons and limes at people. The Sulk. And Dr. Long Island. Way cheaper than Dr. Manhattan.
Sure. All right, those are nice. Okay, Genevieve, what do you got?
All right. Conan the Barber. Ironic Man.
Right.
Credible Hulk. Sure. Iron Fiscally Conservative.
Oh, as opposed to Iron Fist. Okay. All right. Iron Fiscally Conservative, sure. Okay.
Guardians of the Galleria.
They've been looking for work.
Black Pander.
I thought that was Martin Lawrence. Oh! Yeah. Thank you.
You've heard of Wanda Maximoff, but what about Wanda Minimoff?
Or Maximon. What about Wanda Maximon? All right.
And finally, Blunder Woman.
Blunder Woman. Oh, she just can't get it right. All right. Slater, read them off for us.
All right. We got the Green Lanyard. Comedy Festival.
Sure.
Super Spreader Man. Nick Perturbed. Not Nick Fury.
Right. Just Perturbed. Yeah. And he doesn't have an eye patch, he just has a sty.
Yeah. Red Skull.
Oh.
Got a problem with sure. Chewing tobacco. Dead Above Ground Pool. Guy looking for a weird sound in his house in the dark carrying a baseball, Batman. We'll end with that, I guess.
Yeah, dynamite. Excellent work. I loved it. All right. Murray, moving on to Murray Valeriano. What do you got for us?
I had Aqua Velva Man also.
Mm-hmm.
Point. Do I get a point for that?
No. Only the first person gets it.
And I had another similar later, a Dead Kitty Pool.
All right. Sure.
The Flasher. He shows you his wiener real quick.
Real quick, yeah.
Real quick. And then this is a list. You got to listen to the cumin torch.
The cumin
torch. The cumin torch, usually partnered up with daredeviled eggs. That's it. That's all I got.
Outstanding work, Murray. Well done.
Thank you, sir.
All right, Craig, knock us out. What do you got?
Oh, gosh. Instead of Dr. Manhattan, the Newark Orderly. instead of the Fantastic Four, the Scholastic Three plus the Syphilitic One with pronouns Herm and Sherm.
Okay.
Mr. Fantastic will now be known as Sonny Simpatico. Human Torch, how about Anime Candle, which is also my dance name on the main stage. instead of Doctor Strange, the Silly Intern. Instead of Hellboy, the Purgatory Kid. the Incredible Hulk is the petulant drunk. And what else do I have here? instead of Aquaman, Snapple Man or Brita Man. How about Deep Purple Panther?
Oh, there you go.
I like that. Kind of psychedelic.
I got a couple more. Conan the Librarian, of course.
Sure.
The Skimboarder. how about instead of Iron Man, the Copper Fellow?
The Copper Fellow. Plastic
Man, Silica Joe. And instead of Swamp Thing, how about Creek Business?
Did you just open up a thesaurus and go to work?
I don't teach during the summer.
I that makes sense. That's perfectly fine.
This looks like a job for Creek Business.
All right, Shelby, you're last. Show us what you got.
I got a lot.
Let's hear it.
Doctor kind of weird, not quite strange.
Got it.
Black house cat. Tap water man. Chore instead of Thor.
Chore.
Cast iron man.
Cast iron man, sure.
The incredible Hulk. I think somebody else had something similar.
Yes.
Captain Trump's America. Dead bird in the pool. Pet tarantula man. Middle-aged mutant ninja turtles.
Sure, they're getting on.
RoboCop on paid administrative leave. Conan the O'Brien.
Whoa, that's a new way to go. I like it.
Pooper man.
Yeah.
Swamp ass thing.
He never wipes.
And silver couch surfer.
Silver couch surfer. So while Galactus is in town, he's like, Silver Surfer's like, oh, I gotta find a place to crash. He never gets me a hotel. I hate it. All right. That was all good stuff. 80s Lisa in the chat room said CNA Oc. That's a good one. All right.
I know her.
Oh, there you go. She's probably watching to see you, so maybe you actually try. You know what I mean?
She knows what's good for her.
All right, that's the end of that round. Steve, give us the scores now.
We've got Shelby in the lead with 19, followed by Craig with 17. Genevieve with 14. And Andrew, Murray, and Corey at 10 apiece.
All right. So now you know where you stand. Everybody's on the board, but there's plenty of game to play. Let's move on to our next round. Where's this theme? Oh, here it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, name that tune.
That's right. Name that tune. Everybody's favorite part of the game. This is how it works. Oh, but before we do that, Steve, did you have something, a commercial or something you wanted to read?
Oh, yeah. Let me pull that up here.
All right.
Quentin Tarantino and Uwe Boll present the crossover hit of the summer. In the future, Warner Brothers will own more franchises than it has platforms to stream them. So it decides to have all of its characters face off in one gigantic free-for-all. Do you dare miss the future of entertainment by not seeing The Suicide Jam, starring Ryan Reynolds as Gandalf, Margot Robbie as Lola Bunny, Idris Elba as LeBron James, Daniel Radcliffe as the guy who is just trying to move on with his life, and a special appearance by Don Cheadle as the Emmy nominee who needs a paycheck.
Make sure to
watch the spectacular now so that you're prepared for the 18-hour cut that we will release in October. Suicide Jam Fever, catch it.
Excellent. I've already caught it. I got vaccinated for it. All right. So thank you, Steve. Next game up is Name That Tune. So what I need you all to do is go to buzzin.live. I put it in the chat here, the Zoom chat. Go to buzzin.live and then hit join game and then put in the code that I included in the chat. And that's what we'll use for Name That Tune. While they're doing that, I'll explain to you. It's very simple. I have some songs here. I'm going to play them. Whoever buzzes in first with the correct name of that song gets a point. If they buzz in and they're wrong, I'll continue to play it for someone else. Let's clear the buzzers. Now, these first songs are all from movies. So after you buzz in and you tell me the name of the song, if you can then tell me the movie it's from, I'll give you a bonus point. All right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're waiting for Craig still. You got it, Craig? Oh, you're muted.
Oh, he's going Slater on this.
Yeah,
he's going Slater. It's great when it happens to somebody else.
You go to buzzin.live. There you go. So everybody's in now. Okay, so if you want to test your buzzer, go right ahead. Let's go ahead and buzz in, and let's make sure everybody buzzers work. And one more, Murray. Excellent. Okay, everybody's buzzer works. All right, so you know how to play. I'm going to start. Like I said, all of these are from movies. So when you buzz in, make sure you know the name of the song. But if you can then tell me what movie it's from, you'll get a bonus point. All right? You ready? Here we go. Name this tune. Oh, that's Murray first. What's that song, Murray?
Oh,
I said buzz in when you know the song.
It's Tiny Dancer.
Yes, it's Tiny Dancer. Give it a listen. Give it a listen.
Okay.
Tickets are forgone. Turning back, she just laughs. The boulevard is not that bad.
All right, what movie is that from, Murray?
Fuck, I'm blanking on the name of it. 80s Lisa's gonna kick me in the nuts. it's the Cameron Crowe movie. It's,
yep.
I can't think of the name of it. I'm drawing a blank.
What is it, everybody?
Almost famous.
Famous.
Yeah, there you go. Right, everybody right, else right. knew it. All right, so that's 1 point
the
for
Andrew
Murray.
Slater story.
Hey.
Burn!
This is a roast.
Damn. All right, buzzers reset. Name this tune. When the truth eats foul. That's Murray first. What's that song, Murray? You just buzz in no matter what, don't you?
No, I know what it is. I don't know what movie it's from, though. That's what I was saying.
What's the song?
Don't You Want Somebody to Love?
There you go. Somebody to Love is what it's called. What movie is this from?
Is that from the Cable Guy?
That's right. It's yes! Jim Carrey from the Cable Guy. Good job. That's one of my favorite scenes. All right, 2 points for Murray.
I forgot about that.
He's right. Dominating. Name that tune so far. Here we go. Buzzers reset. Name this tune. That's Corey first. What's that song, Corey?
Oh, you beat me.
Oh God, what the fuck is the name of it? I don't know what movie it is.
What's the song?
It's yep.
Yeah?
Fuck.
I'm gonna have
my
to
wife is gonna kill me.
Go to someone else.
Go to someone
Sorry,
else.
Sorry, Murray. What's the name of that song, Murray?
Now I got the fucking Pet Shop Boys cover of this in my head and I can't think of the title.
All right. Anyone else wanna buzz in and try
I'll pass, I'll pass.
No one else wants to buzz in?
I love you, baby. Night, I need you, baby. The only night I need you, baby.
Oh my God.
Me when I say.
So nobody's got it, I guess, is the answer. The song is called Can't Take My Eyes Off of
right.
You.
Son of a bitch.
Just too good to be true. And what movie is it from, Corey?
10 Things I Hate About You.
That's right. That's the late Heath Ledger. All right. Buzzers reset.
I get a point for that at least?
Nope. Buzzers reset. Name this tune.
I run for the bus, dear. While riding, I think of us, dear. I say a little prayer for you.
That's Corey first. What's that song?
Ah, beat me, damn it.
I just assumed the name of that song was I'll Say a Little Prayer for You.
That's what it's called. Good job.
Cool.
What movie is this from?
At work, I just take time. And all through my coffee break time, I say a little prayer for you. Forever and ever, you stay in my heart.
Any idea, Corey?
I don't know.
That's from
the last movie I saw was Kung Pao Enter the Fist, so whatever.
That's from My Best Friend's Wedding with Julia Roberts. That's Rupert Everett singing at the rehearsal dinner. The great Rupert Everett. All right, buzzers reset. That's 1 point for Corey. Buzzers reset. Name this tune.
1, 2, 3, 4. Bum.
That's Shelby first. What's that song, Shelby?
Sweet Child of Mine.
And what's it from?
From Step Brothers.
Very good.
Wow.
That's Adam Scott and his family when they're on their way to meet the rest of the family. Very good, Shelby. You got 2 points for that one. All right. So now these next songs, as you know, are all mashups. They don't worry about what movie they're from because they're not from a movie. But when you buzz in, you have to tell me both songs that are mashed up. They're two songs mashed up together. So tell me both songs, all right? Here we go. Name these tunes. That's Corey first. What are those songs, Corey?
It's Sweet Home Alabama.
And?
And the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air theme song.
Wow.
Outstanding, Corey. Good job. That's 1 point for you. He knows his theme songs. All right. Buzzers reset. Name these tunes. That's Corey first. Go ahead, Corey.
It's All Star and Shooting Stars.
That is not what it's called.
Damn.
Anyone else want to buzz in? Nobody? It's All Star and Fireflies by Owl City.
Fireflies.
Fireflies is the name of that song.
Who does Fireflies?
Owl City.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Owl City. All right. Buzzers reset. Name these tunes. Holy shit. Corey, once again with the early buzz. What are those songs?
One of them is Wild Wild West.
And the other one?
Is the other one the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air again?
That's a fix.
Hey, look, sometimes we get a Will Smith fan on the show. It's just how it works out. I'll tell you this, if you've played this show before, you should be fluent in Will Smith songs. I shouldn't have to tell you that. All right, that's another point for Corey. Buzzers reset.
Wait, he only got one of them.
No, he got both.
He did?
Wild Wild West and the Fresh Prince. Yeah, he said both. All right.
Superstition. I didn't hear Fresh Prince. I quit.
There we go. Oh, darn it. He's gone again. I think you'll get this one, though, Craig. Name these tunes.
Go home to Bel Air.
Once again, that's Corey. God. What are those songs, Corey?
So one of them is the theme song to The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
That's correct. And the other one?
And the other one is the music from the Me Channel.
That's
from
right.
Nintendo's Wii console.
That's exactly what it is. Very good, Corey. Got to have a Nintendo Wii to know that one. All right. One more song in this round. Corey is dominated. Here we go. Name these tunes. That's Murray first. What are the songs, Murray?
I'm just going to assume it's the theme from The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
And?
And Wonderwall.
That is incorrect.
Out, all right.
Whoops, wrong one. That is incorrect.
That was right.
All right, Corey, what are the songs?
It's It Is Wonderwall.
And?
And it's You Spin Me Round.
That's right. Very good. Corey dominated that round. I don't even know if we should find out what the scores are. Steve, how does it look?
We have Shelby in the lead with 21, woo, followed by Craig with 17.
He left.
Craig with 17, Corey with 15, Genevieve with 14, Murray with 13, and Andrew with 10.
Wow. All right. So we know who has a chance and who is completely shut out at this point. But we have one round left as we go ahead and play our final round. Who wants to beat a geek? This is how this game works. Before the show, I asked everybody to tell me a field of pop culture or trivia that they felt they were an expert in. So they did that, and Steve and I came up with questions in each of those categories. So once again, read me the standings, Steve, so we can see what order we go in. You said Shelby was first.
Shelby was first, followed by Craig, then Corey, then Genevieve, then Murray, then Andrew.
And Slater is last. Okay, so that means Shelby, because you're in first place, you get to go first as we ask Slater his trivia question. Now, Slater said he was an expert in 1992 NBA. So it's up to you, Shelby. You can choose to answer this question or you can have Slater answer it. If Slater answers it, he moves on to the next round and you're eliminated until we come back around to you. What do you think, Shelby?
No, I don't know
dick
about that.
All right. All right. So she's going to let Andrew Slater answer it. All right. Slater, here's your question about 1992 NBA. Who did the Portland Trail Blazers beat in the conference finals to take on the Bulls in the finals that year? Who did the Portland Trail Blazers beat in the conference finals to take on the Bulls in the finals that year?
That's a good one. That is a good question.
I was living in Chicago at the time, so I remember this distinctly.
You know the answer. Okay.
Yeah.
I think I know the answer, but I just want to talk it out to myself. I am going
take
to
your time.
Go. Play that one more time.
It's on a loop.
Yeah. That's good. No. I'm going to say... There it is. The Houston Rockets.
You say it was the Houston Rockets. Is that your final answer?
Yes.
He says that the Trailblazers beat the Rockets to go on and face the Bulls. The correct answer is the Utah Jazz. Oh, so close. That was a good guess. But it was the Utah Jazz. Good call, Shelby. She left because she knew that Slater wasn't going
to
answer.
No, I had to go pull over. Sorry.
That's okay. I'm still in. But that means that Andrew Slater, you've been eliminated. Give him a hand, everybody. You did your best. Next up is in fifth place is Murray, who said he was an expert in Beatles-era McCartney. So, Shelby, what do you think? Do you want to answer this question about Beatles-era McCartney, or do you want Murray to answer it?
No, go for it, dude. I don't know.
All right, Murray, this is your chance to take over. If you get it right, you're in the driver's seat. If not, Shelby keeps going. So, Murray, here's your question about Beatles era Paul McCartney. Whoops. There we go.
Wait, how many theme songs am I getting?
You can get all of them as far as I'm concerned.
One fuck Slater up, three are going to fuck me up, man.
There you go. How many is that good?
That's perfect.
Okay, thank you.
This is what Bob Bowden hears when he closes his eyes.
That's an inside joke. All right. Now I got to turn all this off. Okay, so Murray, this is your question about Beatles era Paul McCartney. You ready?
Okay.
Here we go. When Paul McCartney wrote the song When I'm 64, he had originally hoped to sell it to which famous singer? McCartney wrote the song When I'm 64, he had originally hoped to sell it to which famous singer?
Dude, you took a deep dive. I really feel like I just read this not too long ago.
Pretty famous.
Yeah. I'm just gonna go. I'm just going to go Elvis. I don't think that's right.
So you say Elvis. He wrote When I'm 64 for Elvis Presley. Is that your final answer?
I think so.
He originally wrote the song for Frank Sinatra.
Damn it.
Because it's kind of a poppy tune. All right, Shelby, good call. So far, with no work done whatsoever, you're staying in the driver's seat. Good job. Murray's been eliminated, though. Thank you for playing with us, Murray. I appreciate it. Next up is Genevieve. Genevieve said she was an expert in Mad Men, the TV show Mad Men that Craig Anton was on. That's a little too meta for me. So here's the question about Mad Men. But Shelby, do you want to answer it or do you want to have Genevieve answer it?
I don't know anything about that either.
All right. Excellent. Okay. Here's your question about Mad Men, Genevieve.
What character did Craig Anton play?
Cancer guy. All right. Here's your question, Genevieve. At one time, the firm on Mad Men was called Sterling Cooper Draper Price. Give me all those characters' first names.
Whoa.
At one time, the firm on Mad Men was called Sterling Cooper Draper Price. Give me all those characters' first names.
Okay, we got Roger Sterling, Bert Cooper, Don Draper, and Lane Price.
Whoa!
So you say it's Roger, Bert, Don, and Lane. Is that your final answer?
Yes.
She says it's Roger Sterling, Bert Cooper, Don Draper, and Lane Price. That is exactly right. Well done, Genevieve. So now she's in the driver's seat. Shelby is eliminated for the moment, but you will get a chance to come back since you're in first place. But Genevieve, you now are in the driver's seat. You haven't been eliminated. Next up is Corey, who said he was an expert in Friends. So Genevieve, you get to decide now. Do you want to answer this question about Friends or do you want Corey to answer it?
And that's the TV show, not having Friends. I don't know anything about that.
Yes, the second TV show named Friends, because there was one before it.
Yes.
Oh, man. Well, I watched Friends. Yeah, I'll try it.
You want to answer it? Okay, she's going to go for it. So if you get this right, you move on and you've eliminated Corey. If not, Corey gets to take the driver's seat. Here we go. Genevieve, what was Monica's nickname when she played goalie for her childhood soccer team? This is easy for Friends fans, but maybe not for otherwise. What was Monica's nickname when she played goalie for her childhood soccer team?
Oh man, I know it was fat phobic. That's fun.
Most likely if it's a question about...
I'm being intimidating.
Look how intimidating
I have the answer here.
Do you want to give it a guess, Genevieve?
Oh, no.
Nothing at all. What's the answer, Corey?
Big fat goalie.
Big fat goalie is correct. That's right, big fat goalie. So you were right that it was certainly a fat phobic comment. But then again, any joke about young Monica is going to be a fat joke, so... that's easy to do. All right. So that means Corey is now in the driver's seat. This is going to be hard because the next up is Craig. Craig said he was an expert in Naomi Osaka, the tennis player, who has a Netflix documentary all about her currently. So obviously Craig's been watching that documentary. So Corey, it's up to you. Do you want to answer this question about Naomi Osaka or would you like Craig to answer it?
I would really like to watch Craig answer a question about Naomi Osaka.
As would we all. All right. So
who did
Craig...
you think you're going up against, her mom?
Craig, you ready for your Naomi Osaka question?
I'm pretty sure I didn't say Naomi Osaka.
I'll read you the entire email if you want. You made a joke. You said famous living popes was the one you wanted to go with first.
Yeah.
But then you said, no, not that one. And I said, do you want to just go with tennis? And then you said, yeah, Naomi Osaka. Says right there, let's go with tennis, Naomi Osaka. So right. Here you go. Tennis. Here's your Naomi Osaka question, Craig.
Get it in the box.
Okay. Oh, he knows the tennis word.
Seemed like get it. Here's your question about Naomi Osaka. Who did Naomi Osaka beat in her WTA debut at Stanford in 2014? Who did Osaka beat in her WTA debut at Stanford in 2014?
Well, I didn't play her.
It wasn't me either.
Boy, it could be nearly anyone.
If they play tennis, then yeah.
I'm going to say Martina Navratilova.
Okay.
No, I'm kidding. That's not my final answer. I'm going to say Billie Jean King. No, I'm going to see how far back I can go. Bill Tilden.
Arthur Ashe.
Who has a great quote, by the way, tennis matches are not won, they are lost.
Oh.
Similar to this round of questioning, I will add.
That's right.
I'm gonna throw a guess out there and say Bencic.
Bencic is your answer. Is that your final answer?
Her last name, Belinda Bencic.
Oh, okay. Belinda what? Say it
Bencic.
Again. Okay. And that's your final answer?
No. I could keep guessing.
Clearly not.
Let's get on with it.
Why don't you make up some more names?
All right. His answer is Belinda Bencic. That is, of course, incorrect. Samantha Stosur was the young lady's name.
That's incorrect, too.
No, it's right.
That's also made up.
No, I Googled that. It is
we
made up. But
Stanford.
That's not her real name. All right. Good call, Corey. You survived that round. Now we go back around. Let's see, Craig. So that means, yes, we go back around to Shelby because she's in first place. And so it comes down to this final question, Corey. Shelby said she was an expert in Seinfeld. So you have to decide, Corey, do you want to answer this question about Seinfeld or do you want the Shelby Sacamano, who just finished her online Seinfeld quiz,
right,
to answer this question. Like I said, if she gets it right, she's the champion. She has won the game, but you've won yourself. You ran this this whole game before. So what do you want to do?
Hide. I can't let the person who willingly spent time in a Zoom for Seinfeld trivia take the Seinfeld question.
But I'll she finished to... poorly.
She did.
It's true.
Right. But she just heard a bunch of Seinfeld answers.
Mm. Good point, Corey. So,
good point.
I'm going to have to go for it, Paul.
All right. So that means if you get it right, you are the champion of this game. If not, Shelby has won two games in a row. Here we go. Here is your question about Seinfeld, Corey. Very simple. What is George Costanza's middle name? The question again, what is George Costanza's middle name?
So easy.
Well, any Seinfeld fan should know it, that's for sure. What do you think,
Corey? I want to hear the light cue like eight more times.
Well, the longer you take the answer, the more you get to hear it.
If you produce game shows for ABC and they fail, they put you in a room and loop this over and over again. This is Rob Mills.
That's
torture.
What killed Jamie Tarsus.
Jesus.
I mean, I had to take it because I'm sure, Shelby, you know the answer to this.
Chances are she does, yeah.
Yeah. So
you
I
made
mean,
the right decision anyway. Do you want you want to just give it a guess?
I'm going to take a guess.
Okay.
And say, I'm going to guess Susan.
Susan! His fiance's name. That would have been a weird coincidence. All right. So, Susan, is that your final answer?
It's going to have to be, because I got nothing else.
He says Susan. That is unfortunately incorrect.
Yeah, no shit.
Shelby, do you know the answer, Shelby?
Lewis, GLC, the Frogger episode!
Yes, Lewis, GLC, George Lewis Costanza. That means your champion once again is Shelby Gonzalez. Give it up for her. Shelby, two in a row. How does it feel to be the reigning champion of all your favorite game shows, Shelby?
Second best day of my life.
Well, let's make it even better by singing along. Let's all sing together, everybody. Come on. Well, all right. Okay. You win. You are the champion. Well, all right. Okay. You win. Can you do it again? You won the game tonight. And everybody's feeling right. Thank you, everybody. This is all your favorite game shows. On behalf of Corey Annotato, Genevieve Rice, Andrew Slater, Murray Valeriano, Shelby Gonzalez, Craig Anton, Steve Mandel, and myself, thank you for watching. And remember, if you trust a Republican, you're a stupid motherfucker. Good night, everybody. Oh. There we go. All right, that's it. Show's over. We're off now. Thank you guys very much for doing it. You guys are all hilarious
no
and
problem.
Funny. I appreciate it. I really appreciate you guys doing this. If for you guys who aren't in Arizona,
it was a blast.
If you come to Arizona and want to do the live version, let me know.
Where do you do the live version at?
It's at the Grid.
Arizona.
It's at the Grid. It's a barcade in Mesa. But they think I'm famous, so they let me do whatever I want there. All right, thanks guys for playing. I appreciate it. Have a good night. See you later.
Thanks, guys. Nice to see everybody.
Likewise. Take care, everyone.
Goodbye, Corey.
Goodbye, Murray.
Dun 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 dun.
See you later.
See ya.
Bye, Paul.
He can't hear us. His headphones are off.
All right. Well, I'll see you soon.
I'm all tangled
Bye.
Up.
Wait, Paul, can you hear me?
Yeah.
I have something to show you. I don't know if you've ever seen it.
Oh, it's just us now. Everybody left.
Yeah, it's just us. Have you ever seen the first pilot to match Game 73?
Oh, no. I saw the first of the original one, but I never saw the
so
first
I'm
pilot
gonna,
for
I'm
the
gonna
new
try
one.
To play this to you. A friend sent me a clip from Pilot B. And there's a reason why...